Good morning, everybody. It is Jamie. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Riddler Studios. It's Friday, and I'm so sorry that I couldn't be here with you yesterday. I had appointments and errands from early on till late last night, so it was a busy, busy day. Including one of the things I had to do was try to find a pair of comfortable, good walking shoes or the like for my trip to Holland. And isn't that hard? Oh, it's the hardest thing to find really comfortable footwear, and that's also maybe a little stylish. But I did. So let me share with you what I got. I'm so excited. Look at. Are they awesome? So it was very exciting because I looked at a million sort of standard black short boots because I just wanted something that would work with anything that I was wearing while I was on my trip to Holland. And then as the sales clerk was getting me those, I saw these. And I had a moment where I thought, teal, is that crazy? And then I went over my entire wardrobe and the color story. And that is something I learned from the wonderful Safina Kamani, who is a style consultant and who I worked with a couple of years ago and had the most amazing time. And one of the things she taught me is it's really helpful to work within a palette that is all interrelated, that can all work together easily. And so I thought, well, what do I wear? Black, white, gray, sometimes a little blues, purplies, pinks, all that. I'm like, all good. And I put them on and they fit me. And I don't remember the last time I put on a pair of shoes, and as soon as I put them on, I'm like, those are comfortable. So I will tell you better how they fare after 2 weeks traveling Holland. I'll come back with a report. These are made by Cobb Hill, by the way. I remember a couple years ago I decided I wanted to become a more confident traveler. And I've come so far, except for I'm still afraid of flying. And I think I'm always going to be afraid of flying. I do have some strategies for that, but the other parts, the parts that I used to find so intimidating, like how does an airport actually work? And what should you know before you go through security? And I didn't understand anything like from ticketing or seat selection or anything. And it all seemed overwhelming and like opaque. Like there were no instructions, you know, like somehow everybody else in the world seemed to understand how it all worked except for me. So I did some research. I asked for a lot of help. You know, I just asked people, anything, like, what do you bring when you travel? What do you make sure never to leave behind? Or how do you deal with being afraid of flying? Or, and so, then it really is just about having the experience and getting out there and trusting yourself and doing what you need to do. So I took my time. Sometimes I would get to the airport really, really early, so I could take my time to look, to ask, to understand, to observe. We introverts, you know, we like to observe to understand things. And I've come, like I said, so far from feeling like it was all so intimidating to now I have traveled places by myself. I have traveled in Canada. I've traveled in the States. Justin and I went to France, and that was a big step for us because it was traveling in a country where the language wasn't the one we spoke. Plus, it was the first time we traveled between locations on the same trip. So each thing has been a step in growing my confidence, and it's really opened up the world for me, and I'm so thankful for that. To become more confident in something, we have to take some risk. We have to step into something where we don't feel so comfortable and manage it. I don't mean necessarily succeed at it. I mean, whether you do or you don't, whatever happens when you take that step, you manage it. You know, it's okay. So you forgot something. What do you do when you forget something? There's something to learn. So you, both of you walked up to customs and they only want one of you to walk up to customs at a time. Now you know that. And I found that by asking and remaining polite and patient, that everything seems to, knock on wood, start to work out. So today I'm having a meeting with my resident web Sherpa, Kim. Hey, Kim. And I am so excited because one of the things we are doing is we are moving the hosting for Jamie Riddler Studios over to WordPress Engine, where it'll have a lot more security and a lot more support. And hopefully from your end, nothing will change. It might be a little bit faster. Yay, that's always good. And because it's more secure, we won't have any interruption in service like we have had over the past year. So I'm totally excited about that. Plus, I have to make the welcome video for the full Corn Moon Dreamboard Workshop, which will be available to you on Monday. I gotta say thank you to Ginny, who so wonderfully helped me by going over the full Corn Moon Dreamboard Workshop to make sure that it was clean, tidy, neat, and ready to go. So thanks, Ginny. Have a great day in your studio, and I will see you on Monday.